And then came to our Venus planet. Via Venus planet, he came to our Earth as a person having a body. This Sanat Kumara. More is, if we proceed more, it will be confusing, but yes. No. This is the formation of the globes. This is this is the grassiest.
Yes, and that's the planet Earth too, right?
Yes. And up to fourth, there are humanities in all these stages, but the fourth stage is the tangible humanity existing on this Earth, the fourth root race. Yes, exactly. And fourth, fifth and sixth root races will be found on the physical bodies only on the fourth stage. Because differentiation of sexes occurs only on the fourth stage. In the previous stages, there is no physical body. And for the present, what we want is, you know, convert these things into arcs of circles instead of straight lines. This is the outermost layer of creation. You proceed from circumference to center. 1, 2, 3, 4. There is the fifth, seventh. That is the Mahaparinirvanic plane. This is the physical. That is cosmic physical. Yes. This is the cosmic astral or the etheric, cosmic etheric, cosmic mental, and cosmic buddhic, cosmic nirvanic, paranirvanicam and mahaparanirvanic. These are the cosmic planes. With this superimposed diagram, if you proceed into the study of the cosmic fire, it will be a little bit easier. So, in total, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And if the first 4 includes 7 globes of one chain, the creation contains 7 stages, 8, 9, 10 stages. So the fellow Purusha stands on Earth on 10 digits. Yes. That is why it is described in the ancient Tibetan Buddhistic symbolism like this. And the outermost fellows, they form the first 3, 1, 2, 3, and then the other 7, they represent the 7 globes of the chain. So these 3 fellows are called the Dhyani Buddhas of every creation. They are called the Dhyani Buddhas. That means, no, these 3 Dhyani Buddhas, these 3, that means Dhyani means meditator. Secret doctrine law, DZY, yes. DZ? Yes, it is ancient Sanskrit. Dhyani means meditator. One who meditates himself out into creation. That is uttering. Pardon? He meditates himself out as creation. As creation. That is how these 3 fellows do. That's why they are said to imitate the Purusha. That is, they offer themselves into the sacrifice as the creation. These 3 fellows, quality 3, you can say they are the lords of the 3 main qualities beyond the race. These fellows, they come under the race. They are beyond race. Yes. Yes. Brahma, Vishnu and Maheshwara, you remember? Jnani Buddhas is the name of these fellows given in the ancient Tibetan symbolism language. And now, let us enter into the meaning of this stanza. The first should be split up into 2 words like this. Veda and Aham. Veda means no. Aham means I. You remember Soham? I am. He is myself. Soham means. The word soham means he is myself. So vedaham means I know. And also you should split up here etam. Vedaham etam. There are three words in it. The first etam. This. And then purusham means the purusha. I know this purusha. Good. Purusha is very happy today. Purusham means purusha. The total means I know this purusha. Mahantam means the biggest. Also the greatest. It means the biggest or the greatest or the grandest. Any one of the three meanings you can take. The word means three. So I know the purusha who is the biggest, the grandest and the greatest. That is the first sentence. The second sentence, Aditya plus Varnam. Sun. Varnam means ray. And also Varnam means sound. And ray color or sound. That is the meaning. So I know the Lord who is the sun god having the ray and the sound and color. And the next thing, you have to split up like this. There are two words in this. Tamasaha, tu. It becomes tamasastu. Darkness. Tu is only an idiomatic word meaning, of course, it is used as an assertion. And then the last word, pare, beyond, that is one meaning. To, on the shore, that is another meaning. So, I know the Lord who is beyond and who is on the other shore. Of course, we now give the translation of the stanza also, after finish. Sarvani means all. Rupani means forms. Vichitya means having gathered. Dhiraha, the next word, the stable one. Another meaning is the one who meditates. So the Lord is there on the other shore meditating all the forms of the universe. And also Namani means names. He is also meditating all the names of all the fellows in the universe and all the articles, all the things. Kritva means having made. Abhivadan, next. Repeating. And also, it also means imitating. So the fellow is repeating all the names and all the forms by imitating. That means he utters once and these fellows then begin to utter, the created ones. You remember one verse in the opening pages of the Old Testament? God has shown man all the other beings and he named. That's it. And then it became the name of that beast and that article and that material, like that. That is, the utterance of names comes out into formation. That is the formation of the universes and the created beings. Abhivadan. And finally, this is should be split into two. Yat, aste. Yat means since. Aste means existing. Present tense, existing. It is a little bit complicated than the other stanzas. We now take the translation of the whole stanza. I know this Purusha, the biggest one, the greatest one, the grandest one, who has the light, who has the light and color and sound as his own utterance, and who shines through darkness, from beyond darkness. Full stop. Having gathered all forms, comma, having made all names, he stands stable, uttering them and repeating them in his meditation. This is, of course, it is only an excuse of the translation of this stanza. We cannot totally bring the import from one language to another, especially such stanzas. And here a special note is required for the word Aditya. It is normally exotically translated as sun, but in the esoteric studies every name of sun has its own different function. For example, the word Surya means the same, sun, exotically. Also the word Savita means the sun. All these are translated as the sun. And the word Usha is also translated as sun. But esoterically speaking, it is not sun, but they are all solar gods of the pantheon. Just as Apollo is not sun in the Greek mythology, Apollo is a sun god, not sun, it is a solar god. That is, they are all cosmological consciousnesses who come out in creation. Here, Surya means one who delivers the whole creation. That means larger than physical creation. Delivery and reproduction belong to the physical plane. And Savita means one who gives birth. That's the meaning, etymological meaning. Pusha means one who infills, the living beings. Fills in. These three are called the wisdom, strength and beauty in the ritualistic halls of Freemasonry. Strength and beauty. That is east, west and south. The Pusha is the fellow in the south, called the highest point of illumination, or the noon sun. Pardon?
Wisdom, strength and beauty.
Yes, called the second fellow, Savita. Yes. Yes, Pusha is beauty. And here Aditya is different. Aditya means, you say, don't talk of these ritualistic explanations of Freemasonry. They will kill us because they have a great pledge of secrecy. They should not speak out those things. But of course, I have no obligation because I am not a Freemason. Aditya means the son of Aditya. Now we come to the word here, Aditya Varnam. The son of Aditi. And who is Aditi? she is called the mother of lights, the mother of lights. And she is the wife of the same fellow who married the two wives previously. That fellow had many wives, occasionally marrying one from time to time according to the necessity of creation. So this is another wife of the same fellow called the seer. So Aditi is the mother of lights, and she is what the epics call the primordial deep. She is what we call darkness. If you open the first page and the first stanza and the second line of Genesis, book of Genesis, what is there? Darkness filled the deep. Aditi, she is called Madam Darkness, the grand lady. Tamasa, yes, Tamasastu, Tamasa. So she is the background or the darkness. Who is the mother of lights? Darkness, because darkness is absolute and what we call light is relative, because in the same Rig Veda it is described that darkness to our eye, not to itself. Because of the limitation of the eye, we find it as darkness. So in the Rig Veda it is described as light beyond sight. So those fellows who worked out the mystery of objectivity in the Rig Veda, they say what we call light and colors, they come out periodically from what we call darkness and again go into darkness. Therefore darkness is called eternal light, whereas the light we see is called the periodical light. That is how the sages called Aitareyas in Rig Veda. That is, Aitareyas means those who worked out the mystery of objectivity. They say that this light is periodical, it comes and goes, whereas the background which we call darkness is eternal light. That is the concept of Rig Veda and the scriptures about light. So Aditya means the son of darkness. What do you mean? The ray which produces the sun globe. Not the sun's ray, the ray that produces the sun. You have to conceive two types of rays here. One is the rays of the sun we see, what we call sunlight. And the other is the rays that make the sun. That is pre-solar rays. Yes, they are 7+2 in number according to the scripture, and they are called the lords with variegated turbans. They are described as the lords with variegated turbans. That is, each has a different colored turban on his head. And they have their own three gurus, a total 12, the lords of radiation. These are the 12 lords of radiation whom we have seen in the innermost layer of the egg. We met them in the airport of Geneva. Lords of radiation, the 12. You remember previously we were talking of the 12 fellows, the 11 fellows and the 8 fellows. These are the 12 fellows. They come to their office with colored turbans. All of them, they do not become visible. These two rays, they stay in the background, these fellows also. And these 7, they begin to descend. Yes. The sun globe No. They are beyond materialization and beyond vibration. There is no vibration also. What we call the sun to the eye, he is the lord of vibration. He is on the stage, a next stage. This sun we see with our eyes is called the golden armor or the golden garment of the sun. He is not the sun. The visible sun to the eye is only a vibration. Therefore, he is called the golden garment of the sun god, this sun. That is, yes, the three are among these, all these fellows, they are the one group, the twelve adityas, that is the 12 lords of radiation. No, these 12, they group into 7, 2 and 3. The total, they are 12. They work in the same office.
Pre-solar
rays. And the 11 fellows who are called vibrations, they make the visible sun and the optic light and the audible sound, all these things. That is vibrations. The audible sound is produced by one fellow among these 11. The visible light is produced by one fellow. Like this. So the sun, the sun of the primordial deep or sun of darkness. I know this fellow as the sun of primordial darkness. That means when he comes to the stage of being known by somebody, he can be known only at best as among the 12. Beyond that, you cannot know him. You can be himself because he pervades you, but you cannot know him. The process of knowledge gives only up to this stage. A veil of ignorance surrounds him. Because he is yourself, you cannot know him. Only you can know him only up to this stage, Aditya stage. And how do you know him? Through the varna, that means as light or as color or as sound or syllable. That's all. Beyond that, you can never know him. And finally, the wonderful thing is, he shines through darkness and he is beyond darkness. Because what we know as light shines only through darkness. Without darkness, we cannot have this light. If there is no background of darkness, light cannot shine. Unless there is the sky, which is the great darkness, as the background, the solar light cannot be light. It is because it is relative. It is not absolute. So he shines only through darkness, but from beyond darkness. It is darkness to our mind and our eye. The stage of mind and eye are not capable of perceiving it. Therefore, it is darkness to this. Yes. Because it is dazzling to our eye. Our eye cannot contain it. That's how it is described. Yes. And then, coming to that, exactly the same point here, this is what is called the darkness. The light, the color, and the sound, and the mind through which we perceive, add mind also, and the senses, they form the darkness. Through them only he shines. So they are the layers of darkness, what we call light, color, sound, mind and senses. Through them only the fellow shines, and he is not that. He is not any one of these things, therefore they are darkness. That means, he can be known only through something which is not himself and which is his own form. That is what exactly means. Just wait. First listen to me and then you question. He is known only through his own forms that are not himself in original. Therefore, these are layers of his darkness, that is his non-existence. There are many, just example I have given. So, this is darkness. He shines through darkness. But he is not any one of these things. Therefore, he is beyond darkness. I can see you only. I can see your face, I can't see you. But I talk to you only, not to your face. Each one of us, we see each other. No, we can't. We see the face of each other. But we talk to each other. No fool believes that he is talking to your face. But he can only look at your face. He cannot look at you. But the face is your darkness. Whereas you are different. That's called. And in other words, what he calls darkness here is objectivity. Objectivity. That means not himself. His form is not himself, his color is not himself, his light is not himself. They are only his forms, therefore they are not himself. Pardon? Purusha. Yes. The hero of the story. All his forms, and he is not that. That's why in the later philosophy, that is post-Vedic philosophy, all these things put together are called Maya or the great illusion. And later, unfortunately, the word Maya is understood in a negative sense, in a bad sense. Therefore, they thought that it was something wrong. It is a part of creation. It is neither right nor wrong. It is part of creation. But in the later dates, they are sentimentally understood. Therefore, Maya is misunderstood as something inferior. So, this is about Aditya. That is... No, Aditya is the one in 12 forms. The three gurus are also included in him. A pre-solar race. They are 12, but they are divided into the first three, and then two, and then seven. The total, 12. Post-solar period, that is, you have to come down in the... Before all these things are made, God made himself into two, that is himself and his nature. And his nature himself remained as one. His nature came down as nine natures. Out of the nine natures, the first nature was the virgin nature or the superior nature, and the eight the other inferior forms of nature. That is about his family, himself and his wife, and they conceived all these fellows, and from them these fellows come down. And here, so beyond darkness means beyond objectivity. So he shines through the darkness of objectivity. That means if I see you, the same fellow is existing in you and me also, but that truth is buried in objectivity. Therefore, it is the darkness in which the fellow is buried, and he shines through objectivity. There is only one fellow in two forms, but the one is looking at the other. That is objectivity or darkness. So the fellow is always destined to shine through darkness. Okay?